In this video, you will learn how to reduce video file size without losing the quality of the video, and by using an open source software which is absolutely free, and not only free but best for this job. So let's get started. Hello and welcome to my channel. If this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a brand new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. So there are two main reasons we want to reduce the file size. The number one reason is that it is an important file and we want to keep it safe on an online storage such as Google Drive and Dropbox. And these services give you a limited amount of free storage. For example, Google Drive allows only 15 GB of free storage. And after that you have to pay. And we don't want to pay, and we want to best utilize our free storage so that we could upload maximum number of files. So therefore we want to reduce the file size of our video. So this is the main reason. And the second reason is that to reduce the upload time, because if you are uploading a large number of files, for example when I upload my course on Udemy and Skillshare websites, sometimes a course has 30 videos and maybe 5-6 hours of videos. So this takes a lot of time. And when you are uploading a large number of files and the files are big, chances are that your connection might get interrupted and you lose all the upload and you have to do it again. And to avoid this, we want to reduce our file size. So these are the two main reasons. But at the same time, we don't want to compromise on our quality. There are few softwares. If you use those software, your quality will be very poor. But the software which I'm telling you in this video is free, and this is best for this job. You will get absolutely same quality. This software is called Handbrake. And now I will jump over to my computer and I will show you how to do that.
So first of all, you make sure that you download Handbrake from their original website, which is handbrake.fr. And now I want to show you how much compression or reduction in size we can expect from Handbrake. So these are my course videos and I have a limited space on my Google Drive, and therefore I want to be careful about my file sizes. So I try to note my file sizes, not always, but I try to. So here you can see that 313 MB of video uncompressed. When I compressed it using Handbrake, I got 47 MB, which is a huge reduction in the video file size. There is no direct relationship between how much times you will get the reduction. Like for example, this file is more than 10 times reduction. From 245 MB, we got only 23 MB. It's a huge reduction, but there is no direct relationship. Sometimes it changes, but mostly you get 6 to 10 times reduced file sizes when you use Handbrake, which is fantastic. So when you start Handbrake software, you will get this interface, and now you can drag and drop your file. So the file which you want to compress is called source in Handbrake's terms. Now on the left hand side, I have this folder, uncompressed file folder, in which I have two videos. So these are uncompressed videos. Make sure that you know the folder in which you want to store your compressed videos, because you have to give this folder's name in your Handbrake software. So this is the folder uncompressed. So what I will do, I will just drag and drop my first video into Handbrake. So just drag this video in the Handbrake and release your left mouse button. And now the file is inside the Handbrake. Now there are a lot of options in this Handbrake, and you don't really have to know all these options. I don't know all these options, and I never use all these options, because there is no need for that. We just have to compress the file, we have to reduce the file size, and for that we need only few options which I'm going to explain to you. So don't get overwhelmed with all these options, because this is a big encoder. This can do a lot of other jobs. On the right hand side, you can see these are presets. If you click on this preset button, you will see this tab will open and you will see a lot of presets. Presets are basically pre-configured settings. So they have given name to some of the settings which you can select easily, and those settings will apply in these tabs. So these are the setting tabs. from summary to chapters. If you look here, you will see that there are a lot of settings in these tabs. So once you select any of the presets, those settings will be applied. For normal use, the only thing you want to remember is that you have to apply this fast 1080p 30 preset, and just apply this preset. If not selected, select it. This is the preview of the file, and if you are in summary tab, you will see the preview. If you don't see the preview, it means you are in any of other tabs. So just move to summary tab and you will see the preview of your file. So there are a couple of previews available. You can switch to other previews from portion of your video file, and you can have a look that this is the file you want to compress. Now the next thing is add to queue. So this is applicable if you want to compress more than one files at a time. So this I will demonstrate in a minute. This is the main button, which when you press, the encoding will start and the compression of the file will start, and you have to give a folder name. This is what we will see in a minute. Then this is the queue. If you press here, you will see if there are any files in the queue. So currently there is no file in the queue, because file will only come into queue once you have given the target folder name, as I explained earlier. And now if this is the only file you want to encode or you want to compress, so what you do is first click on the browse button here. And if you don't click on browse and you just click start encode, it will show you the error. So if I click on this, it will show you this error. So this means that you have to give the destination. So therefore, first thing you do is click on browse, and now you give it the name of the compressed file. So normally I just put a C at the end. So editor-c. And so there are two extensions available here, .mp4 and m4v. So we always give mp4, and you click save. And if you go back into the browse folder, still there is no file here, because we have not started any encoding or compression. When you start this, then the file will be saved in that folder. And now if I click on start encode, the file will be saved as a compressed file, and that's it. This is the only thing you need for one file. And let me explain few more things. What I want to do is I want to show you how you can compress more than one file at the same time by using a queue. So as you can see that this if you click on queue, there is no file here at the moment, because we have not put anything in the queue. So if you click on this add to queue button, then this file will be in the queue. And if I press this, as you can see that now we have one file in the queue. And if I click on queue, I can see my file. So let's add another file. So this is the second file. You just drag and drop here again. And now the second file has been added. So again, click the browse button and give it a, by default, it gives M4V extension, but you change it to MP4. You can also put this .-c for compressed file, so you don't confuse with the name if by chance you are saving in the same folder. But normally it is recommended that you save the compressed file in a separate folder. So save. And now if you look at the button has changed from start encode to start queue. And if I click start queue, it will start compressing these two files. Before we do that, I want to explain a little bit of these tabs, and then we will see how it looks when it starts compressing. So the first tab is summary, which only shows what encoder you are using and what are the file sizes. Then in the dimension tab, you can see again that this is the width of the video file and this is the height. This modulus, you always put either 2 or 16. This is recommended. So 2 is the best. If you have some problem, then you can put 16. Then in these filters, normally we don't change anything here. As you can see that all these are off. These filters are useful when you are changing the frame rate from going from one frame rate to another. Then there are some issues which these filters can solve. In the video tab, you make sure that this is set to H.264. This is the codec we use. There are other codecs available, but we use this one. So, and the frame rate is 30. And if you want to see the source frame rate, as you can see here, that the frame rate of the source file is also 30. So you have to match these two. Even if you don't match, it sometimes compresses very fine, but it is recommended that you match the frame rate. It doesn't matter whether you select the peak frame rate or constant frame rate. I have checked with both. Both works perfectly fine. In the summary tab, however, if you look here, I always try to select this. This aligns the audio and video. So always click this. In audio, you don't have to touch anything. Subtitle, you don't have to touch anything. and you don't have to worry about this. Everything is fine if you have selected this fast 1080p 30. So this is the thing you should select, and then all the settings will be here. I don't know many of the settings still, but you don't have to know all these. Now there is no preview because we are in this tab, so just click on summary and our files are here. And now what you can do is you just simply click on start queue, and once we click on start queue, the compression will start. At the bottom you can see this status is changing now, and soon a green bar will appear here, and it will take some time depending on the size of the file, but this is it, and you will get a nicely compressed file with no change in quality. The video quality will stay the same, but the file size will be reduced 6 to 10 times.
So I hope you like this video. If so, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. See you next time.